Hello, I am Jake, and in this video, we are going to make a program to run your programs. But like not like an operating system, just like a Python script that can run other Python scripts. But I'll just show you. All right, so here we are. Obviously, it's pretty exciting so far. We're importing sys, subprocess, and OS, which means so far, you don't need to actually install any pip packages. Yeah. One thing I will note, though, is that we are actually using other scripts. So let me just show you those scripts right now. One is just doing this webp.2png.t. and basically what this is doing is using the pillow library and system to take in an argument from when you call the script, and then it figures out what the output directory and the output file will be called. It opens up that file. This is assuming it's a WebP. Actually, I guess it would work for other things. And then it converts it to an RGB file within its thing. I don't know exactly how it works. And then you can save it and we pass out the file here. Another thing we have is this one, which looks way more complicated, but also uses pillow. And this one takes in a target. And then what it does is basically checks for a bunch of these pixels. And if it finds that a pixel is white, then it will go ahead and it goes over a lot of pixels. This actually takes like a little bit of time sometimes to run. Not like that long, but a little bit. But anyways, if it finds the target color, which in this case, I think is always white, I think I put white in here somewhere. But anyways, I think it's finding white. Oh yeah. If target color is white, because 255, 255, 255 in RGB is white. Then it will go ahead and make that transparent, because if you add a zero here, it's for alpha. So you can make it transparent. So basically it's going over each pixel and trying to see if a pixel is white. And if it's white, it just makes it a transparent white pixel instead. So I have a couple of test images here, this happy face image. So if we ran that through to make transparent, it should make all the corners here transparent. And then this alpha tester image, which is a WebP file. This is a little thing that I made with AI because I'm not an artist, for a little app that I'm working on, because you can be an alpha tester. If you want to, leave a comment. although you probably don't live near me, which is kind of relevant, but whatever. First things first, we're going to just make it so that we can actually run a script from our script. So we're going to first off create a class to do that, which I know class, which can have, we'll have a function where we can call that and pass in a file and some inputs, and we'll go ahead and run that. And well, yeah, so we're going to do that. All right. So we're going to start with class runner, we're going to call it. And within here, we're going to have this init self. It's not going to take in any arguments, and it's going to create a thing called threads. And we're not going to worry about this too much, but you know, we're just creating it for the future, just to be prepared. The next thing we want to do is be able to actually run something as a process, right? We want to execute something. So let's go ahead and create a function called start process. This is going to, it's a function within the class runner. So it has to have self at the start, and then we're going to have file and inputs, and we're good to go, right? not quite. All right. So in order to do this, we're actually going to use this sub process, and it has a function on it called popen, and it takes in some arguments. And I'm just going to kind of write out what we want here. But basically, we're going to eventually do self.threads file equals subprocess.popen some args. And then we're going to say std out, which stands for standard out, which just means anytime you do like print or something like that, that's standard out. And we're going to do subprocess.pipe, which means it pipes. It's like you lay down a little pipe, and then any of your standard out goes through that pipe so that you can see your standard out. Yeah. And we're going to do the same thing for standard error, which is std error. And we'll do subprocess.pipe. And then we're going to say text equals true. What the hell does text do? And this is just going to make it so that whatever the standard out or standard error is, it's going to make it readable as much as it can be. So far, great, right? And then we're going to actually return self .threads file. Perfect. But we don't know what args is yet. So let's define args. So args is actually an array, because if you actually remember one of my last videos, which I will put right up here, we kind of went over that you can use something called argv. And argv is something that is available on system. And we're actually going to use that here. So let's go ahead and kind of explain what that is. So first off, we're going to have a target file. And this is going to be sys.argv1. Now, argv2 is actually the first value, basically, within the list of commands. So let me go ahead and show you what this does. Actually, let me just add one more thing here, which will be the inputs, I guess we'll do. And this will be sys.argv. And we're actually going to say this is 2:. And now if you are a expert of indices, you will know that this means that it's from the second index and on. So anything else after and including 2. That's what we're getting. Now let's go ahead and print target file and print inputs. So now we can go ahead and run this here. We'll do python main.py and let's run it and see what happens. Argv out of range. Great. Because we didn't pass anything. So let's go ahead and pass something. So if I passed hi, we get hi, and then we get an empty array. Because here, we're trying to access, this argv is literally a list. So if we go ahead and print sysargv, we can see that we get this, main.py and hi. So main.py is what we're executing, this script. And then hi is the first value we pass to it. So if we pass like hi, subscribe, what's up? Yeah. I did something. I broke something. Oh, probably the what's up. Hi, subscribe. What is up? There we go. So we have subscribe, what is up as our inputs. Perfect. So that's kind of basically what we're doing here, is we're trying to define what are our inputs to our script. But it's a little bit different. We have to actually specify what are we running. In this case, we want to run Python. And in my case, it's Python 3. So we'll do Python 3. Then we do a comma and then the file. And then we want to pass in the inputs. But the inputs is a list. We can actually even make this a default to a list, an empty list. It's okay, I can just pause. Bye. Everyone says hi. Okay, so then we will do for input in inputs, and we will just do args.append, and we will append the input. So now args is going to look like Python 3 file, which would be, in this case, hi. And then subscribe, what is up? Awesome. Okay, so this actually will already work, which is pretty cool. So let's go ahead and do runner equals runner. So we will go ahead and instantiate our runner class. And you'll notice we're not using some things yet, but that's okay. And then we will, because we don't need anything, we don't need to put anything in the brackets. And then we will do runner.startProcess, and we'll pass in the target file and the inputs. And that's it. So if we run this now, nothing really happens because it's trying to run high, which doesn't exist. And then it kind of just finishes, right? But what if we actually pass in something that's not garbage? All right. So we're going to pass in a call to, actually not, I think I have this ready here. Yeah, let me just copy this. Python 3 main.py with the helper packages web to PNG, or webp to PNG, which is in the helper packages, which is a subfolder here. And then we're passing it this full path all the way to this alpha tester webp. So if we go ahead and run this, we can keep an eye on the helper packages here, and we can see that we now have an alpha tester PNG. So it went ahead and created and ran this. Now we can also just do the same thing. If we just want to change this to, instead of helper packages, webp.png, we can change this to make transparent. And then we can change this to happy face. And if we go ahead and run this command, which I will just do down here, we can see that we should eventually, hopefully, it should show up, hopefully. It's not showing up. Why isn't it showing up? Oh, I said WebP. That's why. JPEG. If you notice the issue, leave a comment, because I did not. I was like, it should be working. All right, let me run again. And we can see that we created this temp file, and then we created this transparent happy face. If we go here, it's transparent. Yeah. All right, so you might say, that's great, but this is kind of annoying because you still have to run the command. And yeah, you'd be right. So what we're going to do is make it so you gets a little bit more interactive. So I'm going to copy and paste a couple things because I don't want to have to write all this again. But first off, we're going to comment this out. And then we're going to go ahead and put this right up, down here. And we are going to have this say a user input is none. And while the user input does not equal Q, you can choose an option, which is, I'm actually going to add another print here because it'll add another line, which is handy. You can choose an option where you can list the programs, you can add a file, you can run the file, and you can also quit. But that means we have to implement list applications, add application, and then, well, run also already kind of exists. But it's actually going to be referencing, it's like not really referencing an application. The application is more just so you can see what's available. So let's do that real quick. So we're going to add list applications, which is pretty simple. We can just go ahead and do list applications self. And we're just going to do applications. And then for app in self.applications, print app. And we don't have self.applications, so we're going to go ahead and make that. So when we create our class, we will create an empty list. And we're good. So that will work. And then we will say def add applications, or application, and we will do self and then name. And we'll just do self dot applications dot append name. Awesome. So that's it. It already works. I mean, I just copied a bunch of stuff in, but it already works. So let's go ahead and we can run this and make it a little bit nicer to use. So if we run main.py, we can see that we have our options here. Let me make this a bit bigger, which is probably going to mess up all of my editing. Thanks, past me. And if we call L, we can see that there are no applications. So let's add an application. So we will do A, and we will do, what do we want? Helper packages, web to PNG. And then we can do A, helper packages, make transparent. Let me go ahead and delete some of these other things so that we can kind of see that they did something rather than just pretending they did something. Cool. And now we can go ahead and do L again. And we can see now we have this helper packages web to PNG and helper packages make transparent. And one thing that I think would actually be nice is maybe we make these numbered so we don't actually have to say like which one we're doing, because I think that'd be nice. So let's do that. So program is actually right before we were taking the user input and splitting it by spaces and then taking the first thing. So let's go ahead and convert this into a number. All right, so we're going to say that this is like this and good to go. And we will do start process program index, right? Pretty cool. Good name, program index. And then we'll do file equals self.applications program index. Heck yeah. All right. So that means that you just have to enter like one or two or whatever. And then we'll make list applications count equals zero. Actually, it should be zero. And then we will do F count dash app. Perfect. It does mean I need to redo this some of this again, but that's okay. All right, so we will go ahead and run again. We will do L, nothing is there. We will do A, pass in some of these awesome scripts. A, pass in this other one. We can do L. We can see that these are here, and I'm not incrementing count. Dang it. Count plus equals one. But we can see quit still works, so that's good. All right. I think we can actually just do this, so that's handy. I'm just doing the up arrow, which is what that's doing. Then we can press L again. We can see these. They are now indexed properly, so heck yeah. And now we want to pass in our values, so we can go ahead and grab this for alpha tester. For alpha tester. I was like, this is making an alpha, so weird. So we will do R, and then we'll do 0, and then we will pass in this here. And if we do this, we should see an alpha tester PNG pop up, and heck yeah, it did. Perfect. So you know what? Let's do our other program of R1, and let's actually pass in the alpha tester again, but let's pass in the PNG. See what happens. It probably will work, right? There we go. It's kind of transparent, I guess. I kind of thought these clouds would be transparent, but it kind of just made the tops of the tops of the things transparent, which is a little weird, but oh well. Cool. So that works. Again, let's make our alpha tester PNG. I don't know why I deleted the other one, but oh well. And we can go ahead and do the make transparent again and paste in our happy face. And we should get a transparent happy face right here. And there it is. Heck yeah. So as you can see, we were able to write a pretty quick program that can run other programs. And that's just the start of this. So in the next video, we're going to add the configs that we talked about before. This file right here, we're going to be able to use this within our runner. And that then means that we can then make it so we don't have to add the programs, and we can save the ones if we do add a program. And then in the video after that, we're going to go ahead and make some UI for this so that you can actually like run this on your computer and like pick a file, you know, rather than typing in a file and getting all of like the slashes wrong. If you're on Windows, it's a nightmare. But yeah, that's it for now. If you like this video, please give it some love down below. And yeah, that's it. I'll see you in the next one. I'm Jake. Have a great day. Cheers.